Lisa Booth is a senior fellow at Independent Women's Voice, and she's followed this closely.
Hey, Tucker.
Lisa, tell me about her conclusions.
Well, her conclusions, as you stated, I mean, basically she goes through all these various inconsistencies that we've seen with Christine Story's Ford's story. But the problem is she's basically remained unquestioned by the media and the left. And that's dangerous because if you're bringing life-altering and life-ruining accusations against someone, your story should be questioned. You go through the inconsistencies. One, every witness that Christine Ford has named has denied the event in question. You go back and looking at the fact she's given different periods of time. She texted the Washington Post mid-1980s, and then she comes to the conclusion in the Washington Post article, it was the summer of 1982. She's given different stories about how many people were there. In her polygraph letter alone, she has two different versions. Originally four people crossed off, and then it's four boys, two girls. And then even if you want to give her the benefit of the doubt of, oh, was it 36 years ago? Maybe her memory's just not straight. Then you go to the recent problems. She said she doesn't remember how the Washington Post got her therapist notes, yet the Washington Post says that she provided them to her. She can't remember when she had the polygraph test. There's this complete farce from her and her attorneys about being afraid to fly. Then it turns out she's flying to Hawaii, Costa Rica, French Polynesia. So we have seen all these inconsistencies, not just with long-term memory, but also with recent. However, nobody's called her on it. And I think the reason being is everybody is so afraid of the Me Too movement, so afraid of these bullies on the left, that they're afraid to call a spade a spade. And she's not credible. Her story doesn't add up. And Rachel Mitcho, this memo, I think, just completely lays all
it's
the facts
amazing.
Bare.
You've been great on this from the very beginning. And
thank you
for your bravery. The whole country's afraid. This was not the country we were promised. Well, we were terrified to say what you think or to be reasonable. And I hope this ends soon.
I have three brothers and a dad.
Yeah.
And so I think about that, and I think it's important.
It's bad for all of us, men and women. Lisa, thank you.
Thank you, Tucker.